Okay, a few hours ago I did a video talking about the comments made by Matt Reeves, the director of the Batman movie that's coming out fairly soon within the next couple of years. Actually, it's going to be a trilogy, but he made a comment saying, quote, "This is a standalone, this isn't part of the extended universe." Now, of course, websites like batmannews.com, which is a pretty good source, span this, and it's really sad that they did this, and so many others have as well. That I've seen, like comicbookmovie.com, another great website, but again, they tend to run with these things after they've overloaded you with ads, like you've got the top of the page here and the bottom of the page. You go on these stories and you usually get bombarded with loads of ads, which is kind of why they publish these stories, and they kind of go a bit viral as well, to the point where the film director kind of got a bit confused by this and went on Twitter basically saying, you know, what the hell is this about? This isn't what I meant. In fact, let's look at this. He tweeted just a few hours ago, geez, what did I miss, guys? Just to be clear, of course, Batman will be part of the DC universe. Batman will be Batman. Now, that means his Batman film is canon. It is part of the same reality as Man of Steel, Batman v Superman, Suicide Squad, Wonder Woman, Justice League, and the other ones. The other films that are coming out in that cinematic universe, the DC Extended Universe. Now, he said it's a standalone movie, it's not part of the Extended Universe. He didn't mean it in the sense of it's not canon, he just meant it's kind of its own thing. So you probably won't see crossovers, any blatant crossovers, kind of like Guardians of the Galaxy 1 when that came out. There was some kind of question. I mean, I knew it was part of the Marvel Cinematic Universe. It had a few little crossovers, but nothing major. But there was some question at the time, is this even part of that? Is it part of that reality? Yes, it was, but it was effectively a standalone film, and it wasn't part of the Avengers universe at that time, meaning you didn't see them cross over with Avengers, but it was part of that reality. Was they are within the same reality, and that technically they can meet, and obviously down the line that's what's happening with the Avengers and Guardians of the Galaxy. That's what Matt Reeves means about this, clearly. Now, I spoke in my previous video, I kind of said, you know, it doesn't necessarily mean that. It seems like spin, and obviously with him tweeting this out, it's taken him by surprise, because that wasn't what he meant. But again, this is the internet again for you. It's just spin, it's non-stories. I mean, it's noteworthy what he said, but if you take it out of context, or if you add context that is a bit to something that is a bit ambiguous, that's why you get these kind of viral stories. And these websites are laughing all the way to the bank, they seriously are. So, I mean, don't get me wrong, they're still great in terms of other things, but it's just these are their weaknesses. It's a real shame. But I'm not going to slag them off, that's not the point of this video. Point is, really, it's not as if the DC Cinematic Universe, or should I say DC Extended Universe is what they've kind of self-titled it, it's not as if that thing isn't hard enough to bloody track as it is with all these false starts and announcements they keep going back on. Without these, the spin machine of the internet making things even more complicated and confusing. So it's kind of like I was talking about this, the exact same thing with the James Bond franchise in a lot of ways. You got a lot of these tabloid reports that are putting out false information, and before you know it, it's kind of established fact when actually it's totally false. So not that it matters. I mean, we're not talking about anything important really at the end of the day. These are just movies, but you know, if you're into this and you get kind of excited by film news, when you hear something like this and you think, oh, that's a good idea. I mean, I was even kind of hypothesizing how good an idea this could be if it was actually true. And it's not true, so that was kind of redundant, me going down that road. But there you go. I'll leave it there anyway. If you want to follow us, you can do. We have like about 12 subscribers anyway. But if you want to kind of hear future news being unspun and kind of bring it back to reality, then subscribe. What do you think as well? Anything else, any other angles on this I haven't covered, let me know in the comments. I'll leave there and say thank you very much for watching.